AgweekTV, presented by Kaler Farms.
The drought in South Dakota has led to historically low crop conditions, according to USDA's weekly report. However, the hardest hit areas are not where most of the corn and soybeans are grown. Michelle Rook looked into how much the drought will pull down state averages.
The drought hit crops early here in parts of South Dakota. The big question will be, what impact will it have on state yield averages, especially for corn? Jeff Gatsky farms near Hitchcock and says with less than an inch of rain in May and June, his dryland corn yields will be down substantially.
It's going to be at least 100 bushels an acre difference between dryland and irrigated. That's going to put you around about 80 bushels at best on the good dryland.
However, in the eastern third of the state, the corn crop has more potential.
Under our irrigation, we're looking at maybe 180 to 200. Some of the dryland have given indications from 125 to 150.
Yet due to the variability, the statewide corn yield will be down.
We're kind of in the camp that's saying probably around that 130, and I think we're probably a little bullish on that. And we're going to be significantly less than last year on the average of all of South Dakota.
There's more optimism about soybeans with the August rains, even for Elk Point farmer Doug Hansen, who planted his beans in the mud.
I'm hoping we can get 50 for beans, maybe upper 40s, something like that.
Even in the drought areas, farmers could have average bean yields.
August isn't all the way played out here, but I think we got some 35 bushel beans out there, maybe 40 in some of the good spots.
However, the state soybean yield will be off of the 49.5 bushel per acre record from 2016.
Oh, I could see us probably off 8 to 10 bushel off of last year pretty easy.
In Mitchell, I'm Michelle Rook reporting for Ag Week.
In the August crop report, USDA put corn yields at 140 bushels per acre, down 21 bushels from 2016. Soybean yield was set at 41 bushels per acre, down 8.5 from last year.